My wife and I have lived on the Priest River since 2007, but we originally bought the property in 1980. We used that as our oasis, our retreat. We've enjoyed the Priest River, floating it, swimming in it, fishing for the last 42 years. My son and daughter grew up with me and my wife recreating on the river, and a big part of that has been fishing. Starting in 1980, you know, I can remember a much more robust fishery. The cutthroat fishery, bull trout, brown trout, brook trout, I've seen the numbers of fish decline every year, and especially in the last 10 years. Because of the hotter summers. And the 2015-2021 were what I call the killer summers. Especially in 2021 in July, that first weekend in July, that fish kill was tremendous. And it was heartbreaking to see hundreds of fish. The mortality was heartbreaking.
Fish kill that occurred in 2021 wasn't really a huge surprise relative to the Priest River. Trout are cold water fish. Priest River's warmer than most of our rivers. It comes from the outflow of Priest Lake, and that's surface water off the lake. And surface water in lakes all over the region warm up throughout the summertime, and it's not a surprise that they got trapped in a hot water spot that they might not otherwise be in, and it led to a fish kill. So we're on the Priest River, late August, and water temperature today is about 72 degrees. That's pretty warm for trout, a cold water fish that relies on nice cold water. So water temperature coming out of Big Creek is about 56 degrees. That's 16 degrees cooler than the main stem of the Priest River today. And that makes a big difference for trout.
Fish can withstand short-term temperature changes, even 70 degrees and beyond, but it's those extended long-term water temperatures that are elevated that really make it challenging to support fish populations in a place like the Priest River. Densities of cold water fish in the Priest River relative to other streams in the region of a similar size are much, much lower. So, for example, the very lowest part of the Coeur d'Alene River, that's good trout habitat, probably has close to 30 times more West Slope cutthroat trout than the Priest River. That's a big difference.
The tribe's been working on the Priest River for a number of years, looking at cutthroat populations and the tributaries that feed to the main stem Priest River. The Priest River has always been really important to the tribe. It's got all the ingredients of being a really good trout fishery. It could have a real economic boon to the area. Got the ingredients, and it's just got, I just think it's got a lot of potential.
I can remember the river as something that was more or less a blessing for all of us. I stand here today and I say this is my problem because I'm a Kalispel. This is my Aboriginal land. This is my Aboriginal waterway. My heart tells me that something is happening. Something is moving. Something is going to happen to better our waters.
The Priest River is a valuable natural resource. It's a cold water fishery habitat. And it's a very, very good habitat. Everything is there except for the water temperature.